guys, first of all, a shout out to my good friend Resident Evil, aka Pesifik. Thank you so much for creating my channel banner and my introduction video. I got to go to bed soon, so in today's video we will do a few elite King Northal videos. I could join him. I'm going to do that. I've got very lucky, guys, when during the last time that King Northal appeared, I got ridiculously lucky because I looted not one but two vanity weapons in one day. So I made close to 5 million in profit. 1.2 million went to Pesifik for creating the video and the banner, and then I saved the rest, invested it in double loot elixirs, luck elixirs, and King Northal elixirs. So in today's video, I'm really hoping that we get lucky again and that we loot another vanity. If we don't loot anything good, I'm fine with that too, since the luck I had in the last King Northal appearance was ridiculous. Let's see, team exists. I'm with three warriors, guys. Three warriors. Wow. I have no idea whether or not this is plus EV. I'm dead. Okay, I'm still alive. Don't know. I'm proccing, it seems. Nice. I'm tapping my spacebar like a freak, hoping that my guy will heal. This is quite ironic. These three warriors died and the rogue is still standing. Yeah, that's to the awesome proc of my weapon. I can't find any other reason for this. Let's see. Isn't Konafest the president of Arler? I think he actually is. Fucking running with the president of Arler, guys. Hopefully a mage or a rogue will hop in. Okay. Yeah, guys, I'm a bit disappointed with the current state of the game. 2 weeks ago they launched those level 16 twink arcane weapon chests. I was quite excited for this event to happen until the moment that I found out and that, unfortunately, until the moment that I found out that this is risky, but I'm going to take the risk. So until the moment that I found out that you can only farm those chests in Elite Dead City, basically that means that there was nothing to do for 1 week, which is okay. Then 1 week later, that was last week, they introduced the Gauntlet edition number 7. Gauntlet, in my personal opinion, is the most boring event in game, so another week wasted. So I was really optimistic, really excited for the event which they would do this week. And now I just read the forum, just G's weekly thread, and apparently there is literally no event this week. So again, 1 week of nothing in Arcane Legends. This just shows for me personally how bad that the current state of the game is. They will launch 3 new mythic pets tomorrow, guys. Those pets will be, you will be able to purchase them with platinum, and they will appear in your stable, so they're not an egg. So you cannot buy the pet with platinum to then resell it as an egg. That's not possible for now. I do know that they will definitely do this in the future, as it is extra income for the company itself. Not really amazed, not really amused, not really impressed by these 3 new pets. I actually don't care about these 3 new pets. But hey, at least it's not something related to the housing, like, yeah, new furniture slots or new vanities or whatever, you know what I mean, guys. So yeah, nothing to do in Arcane Legends Tech next week. This means that I'll probably, this will be the last video for a week, and then hopefully next week we get something nice, maybe. Yeah, you can never know, but I my expectations at the moment are very low. Let's see. I'm also quite I say this in almost every video, guys, but it's the truth. I can't help it. I am so disappointed in how that the customer support works. I mean, I've sent them a mail at the 2nd or the 3rd of May, waited 3 weeks, and then forwarded the same mail again. Do you think that those people bothered on sending me a reply to my mail? They didn't. They completely ignored me. This is such a huge... I find this to be very, very rude. Maybe they have a huge backlog, and they're simply full with mails and work. They are having a delay in responding, which is okay, I understand, but yeah, at least hire someone then temporarily to help. I mean, what the fuck is this with this game? I mean, let's say that I accidentally have an issue with platinum. I buy a platinum pack and all of a sudden it's not possible. I don't get my platinum. I have had that happen to me in the past. Money disappeared from my PayPal. Didn't get any platinum. 2 days later, however, I got the platinum. But yeah, imagine that I'm not getting any platinum. Who should I contact then? Since the Spacetime Studios customer support isn't really interested in responding. I hate it when people join at the very last moment, because this will result in me having to wait with lots of gold invested in Lexus, which are currently taking down. So yeah, I hope that this person is not standing still and is actually moving. That would be great. Yeah, this bow, guys, by the way, I borrowed it from a friend. This friend, shout out to you, Chris, is going to get back the bow later today, because of the simple fact that I don't know how to make it proc. People say just press and top auto skill, like what I'm doing now, but don't know, does it charge? Not really impressed by the bow, but that's probably my bad and not the bow itself. Double, okay. Yeah, I was checking on the Lexus, which I need to open. You know what, guys? It's time that I'm going to open him. Wish me luck. Nee, ga weg. Move. Don't stay there. Connor, oh, nice. Very good, warrior. Let me go into a corner. Hop. Yep. And this. Yes. Where is he? Come on then, you fucker. Imagine that guy looting anything good, that would make me absolutely crazy. Come on. What is this? Oh my god. Go fuck yourself. Oh, this is bad. Oof. So bad. Yeah, we can't be lucky every time, I assume. Damn it. Fuck. I had the chat box closed. Let's see. I'll open these chests and then pause the video for a sec. We looted a... Wow, amazing. A Forager's Tunic of Warfare. Absolutely amazing, guys. Thank you so much, Spacetime Studios. I appreciate it. They will come in very, very, very handy, I think. Pausing the video for a sec, guys, but I will record another run. I'll be right back. Alright, I'll take the risk and I'm going to just hop in randomly. Hopefully that hopefully I don't end up with a bunch of average players. If so, I will remap and do it by myself. I'm going to open one of these and one of these for the armor and crit. That speaks for itself. Okay, guys, here we go. Pop 'em. Okay. Yeah, that's okay. Am I still wearing that bow? Okay. Heal, heal, heal. Thank you. I'm so happy that the dagger broke there, or we would have died already. Oh, nice. Come on. Good. Yeah, that's cool. Well played, Rogue. He has a Necro, that's good. Fuck's sake, idiot. Okay. I'll probably die here. Rehop. That name sounds familiar, but I can't really place it. That's a guildie. Yeah, I've swapped my rogue and my mage from in between guilds because Elite Runners isn't as active at certain times of the day. Which makes it very difficult to find good parties to run with. I mean, I used to have like a fixed group of people who I run with, but yeah, they don't play anymore, or we end up having a fight or whatever. I don't really care actually. Most mobs I can handle by myself, but in mobs like this it's crucial that you do it with a party because the variance is huge in drops, so you need to, if you can have an advantage, advantage being doing this in a party because it's faster than when you do this by yourself, then you should always do so. Okay. Yep. So yeah, Elite Runners, still the best guild, still my home, but not as active as before. And this is all due to housing, if you ask me. I mean, they don't release anything good. The only thing which they are focusing on at this moment is housing, 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 and the occasional PvP drama, and so on. I mean, it's such a pity. The game was so good before. I know that they need to generate platinum and revenue in order to pay the bills, to pay the employees, etc. But they managed to do that perfectly for the first 5-6 seasons. Yeah, I don't get it. I have no idea why that they did this. But in the long term, I assure you that it won't be as profitable as they think because they are pushing away their players. But hey, that's just me being, I don't even know whether or not that's pessimistic. I'm just being realistic about it. This game isn't supposed to be one a game like The Sims or something. I mean, come on, this is a RPG. What is it? MMO, hack and slash, it even says in the description in the Google Play Store. So what the fuck is the usage of houses? I mean, it's okay, it's cool to have a house, but no, I don't need a shower or a bathtub or what is it? I don't even know what the things which are available. But yeah, I think everything is available for your house. I mean, this is another example. I changed subject earlier. This is what I wanted to say. Like, customer support, they don't respond to my emails. On the forum, I see people posting in general discussion. They have questions. People try to think about solutions. Devs, they occasionally, every now and then, maybe hop into a thread, but then they're still being very, very, what's the word, like, vague in the responses which they give. Sometimes they post something and it's still unclear on how stuff works, and so on. However, they released toilets for the house, and I saw that, yeah, a very well-known and respected player, doesn't matter that it's him, he posted on the forum. There was a thread where he asked for toilet paper for his toilet. Yeah, very good, very, very funny too. I had tears in my eyes of laughter. I was crying. I found that thread to be so funny. Not found it to be idiotic, but that's just me. Anyway, so he asked for toilet paper, and guess what? Within a few hours, the one and only Just G was in the thread responding, having a bit of banter with the people in the replying in that thread. I mean, this is something which, in my eyes, yeah, come on, mate. People have questions in general discussion. You guys always seem to be skipping that, but when someone asks for toilet paper for his fucking toilet, you are there to reply. I mean, it's not funny. Solve your shit and then be funny. But yeah, that's just me. I am sure that the guys are working very, very hard to how do you say that? Yeah, to make progress with this game, but for me personally, I don't like it. I don't know, guys. What's your opinion about this? Would you like... Let's say they give us the choice tomorrow and they say, like, let's have a vote, a housing vote. The community can decide whether or not housing stays. Would you actually vote for housing to completely disappear, or would you keep the houses? I'm very curious to see what you people think about this. I've asked it in the line chat, and I was the only one who wanted it completely removed. I got some responses, but yeah, I think that I don't know. Never mind. So yeah, me personally, I want housing to disappear completely. Find something else, find another way to generate platinum and income. I'm sure you can do it, Spacetime Studios. Okay. I assume that my Northal expired. Yep, of course it did. What about my normal look? Yeah, okay. So I only need to open a new bottle. Go away, weg, Riop, weg, move. I'm dead. Nee. Okay. Bad. This is really bad. Okay, I'll do another run, but this time I'm going in solo to see if I'm faster than this group. Because I actually think, I'm not sure. Let's test it. I'll open this one. Yay, and this. Amazing. Thank you. I'm going to open this. Yep. Okay. Potions, I'm okay on those. Yeah, I always try to think about subjects to discuss before I actually start recording. The main issue which I have had for the last couple of weeks is find something positive to say about the game. I mean, It's hard. It's really hard. I mean, one positive thing, for example, is that I got lucky with the vanity weapons, but then again, let's check it out together, guys. Let's check it out before we start our last run. Okay. This guy here, and there's another guy, but he's not here. They're always standing here. Abdel XXX or something like that. Shout out to you, Abdel. Let's see. 175. Let's say that's. Wait, let me think. I'm willing to bet that at least 120 of those runs were King Northal. So yeah, two vanities and 120, that's yeah, okay. I suppose, I assume. Let's check on the Northal next, the time before we leave again. 6:35. I'll probably not make it, but I'm going to run solo just to see how this works out for me. Okay. Could use timer, right? Easier to see how it goes. Or no, you never know. I might disconnect or something, and that will be in my disadvantage. Hop, yep, here I go. This is not elite, I think. Oof. That was a brag, actually. I thought I was a normal because they die so fast. Nice. Uh-oh, this time it's me who is dying. That's the disadvantage of not having razor shield, boys. Ooh, this proc is amazing. Nice. Very good. Nice. It has happened that I died here in the beginning, or at the beginning. I mean, it happens to all of us. Is this really elite? Okay. Those big guys, when they released this expansion, they would one hit randomly. That was so annoying. Wasted tons of angst on those ones. I personally think that they do that on purpose, guys. You might think that I'm crazy, but I seriously think that whenever they launch something new, they make the bosses and mobs extra strong, so people would buy more angst. That's something which is happening, yes, from the very first day that I started playing. Always witness that when they release something, they would make it ridiculously difficult, close to impossible, so people would burn away, spew away angst for the first week, and then they would do something about it because people kept on complaining. Smart move, but actually a sneaky move too. Let's see. Okay, I'm going to open a lurk kit. Once this fight is over, yeah, I do like those daggers, especially when they proc. Nice. For me personally, the best event which they ever organized was the infused arena event where you had double the odds on looting fossil from the chests. Yeah, that was an amazing event. I basically ran arena 10 to 12 hours every day, and I did get rewarded because I looted a fossil. I can run soon. that I wasn't the big guy's red zone. Come on. Die. Oh, yes. Very good. If I kill these ones, I can run. That's my dad. Two bombs. They are glitched, the red zones of those bombs. It's a bit wider than that it shows. Where's the healer? Fuck. Come on. Nice. Yep. So bro, I'm good, thanks. Shout out to you, Frontic, you have done quite some runs with me today, I really appreciate it. The noise which you hear is me spamming the buttons on my keyboard. I rotate mana and health so I can press it faster. Hopefully the boss is up, he should be up. Okay, he is not, maybe I need to kill this these couple of mobs. Ho ho, the dagger started proccing with me still being in my inventory. Come on buddy. Yeah, afterwards, I mean, I'm a bit greedy when it comes to that. I'm not cleaning the mob for people to randomly hop in, and I hate it. Okay, he's up. Swap to the bow. The fuck am I doing? Okay. I am not allowed to die, because if the boss doesn't reset when I die, it means that it's glitched and I have to do it all over again. Time on the double. Ooh, please let me have set. Okay, I should have a few spare ones with me. Come on, jongen, healen. Yeah, I'm focusing. He has killed me before while doing this solo. Several times, to be honest. And all of those kills were legit, like me yikes, getting stunned. Wouldn't mind looting a throne. This is nerve-wracking, guys. I do hope that the sound quality is good this time. Apparently I talk too soft, but I just need to get myself a new headset. My elixir, by the way, guys, the Northal one just expired, which means that I'm faster when I run solo. Think that's because I skipped those mobs. This said, if you run in a full party, you can scale the boss, and we tested that earlier today, and that is profitable to do so. The boss will die really fast. One condition, however, is that everyone has a speed set. Okay, still need to open the Northal one. Please. Yeah, the stakes were. Come on. Come on, and let me loot something good. Beg you. He's dead, but I didn't get anything good. Shoot the hook. Oh, this is awful. Okay, let's see. How long is the video? That's something which I need to know first. Thirty minutes. Ooh. Yeah, wait. Hold on. Okay, it cost me like 10 minutes or so to get this tongue to join, so this will definitely be the last run for today. I'm curious to see how this combination works out, by the way. It's a good start. I wasn't sure whether or not I had the daggers activated or in use not activated. Come on. Nice. Cute soul. I hate PMs during runs. I wish there was an option where you could disable that during the run. Or at least that you wouldn't get the notification, like the pop-up, like covering the entire screen. I wouldn't mind it showing up in the top right corner, but I do not like it when it comes, so yeah, like all over the screen. Most of the time it's people who I don't know asking me to help them with stuff or to give them stuff. Problem with gifting stuff to people in general is that if you give them something, they will always ask for more. Most of the time they forget to say thank you, but they are there immediately to ask for more. That's why I decided to stop doing that. I mean, there's another YouTuber, I'll call him not a competitor but rather a colleague. Yeah, he's, I have no idea, I might have discussed this in another video, but what he is doing really blows my mind. He's like doing contests on a regular basis where he asks people to subscribe. I checked that out. What happens is people, they sign up at like several accounts in order to try and hit and hope they hit, they hope to hit the jackpot in that contest, but those type of subs, they don't really add anything to your community itself. In my opinion, I mean, yeah. And he also has his own guild. He's asking people to join. He has his recruiters. It's okay. I mean, he wants to grow fast. So what he does is he pays people to stand in cities, to recruit people, and the one who recruited most gets a gold reward. I mean, that's okay if you feel like spewing away. Because that's what it is, spewing away gold, so be it. But I do not see any advantage in him. I don't see any logic in it. I mean, if you post good content, my friend, you don't need to bribe people, because that's what it is, it's a bribe. However, it's also a nice gesture of him. I mean, he probably made a few poor people rich, but most of the time people are not satisfied but by the little things which they get, and they always end up asking for more, which is a pity. That's why I stopped giving away stuff. What I used to do back in the day is I would give like noob eggs to people in the cities, but yeah, since they released the trader's permit, that unfortunately has become impossible because no one has trading unlocked. You could try it, go stand in Windmar City, try to get rid of some stuff. It's impossible to get to gift items to people. Nice hit. Most of the time they aren't even aware of the trader's permit and how to obtain it. It's one of the worst things they introduced in this game, aside along with housing, in my personal opinion, because guys, if we are like realistic for a second, if you don't, wait, hold on. Shh. This could have been an intact orc fang, but instead I got the most amazing cobalt pillow. Cheers, Spacetime Studios, I really appreciate it. Anyway, what was I saying? Like, let's say you open the App Store and you type in RPG or hack and slash or whatever, and you download like the five first games which pop up. I mean, what will you do when you enter Arcane Legends and you are not able to trade, sell, gift, receive, get, etc.? Nice hit, guys, really good. In the very, from the beginning, I mean, for me that's a very easy choice. I simply uninstall the app and they will never see me again. It's so disadvantaged. I mean, I know that they did this in order to block people from abusing the reward, where you would get like 5k gold or something in the beginning, because people had bots which would farm new charts all day every day, and they would bink, I think, a few 10 to 100k every day. So in order to prevent that, they introduced the trading permit. I understand the idea behind the concept, but doing the story token quest for 10 days is, it's way too long. Nobody will hold on. Can't imagine new players playing the game 10 days without being able to get better stuff. Jesus, I'm not really paying attention. Damage, speed, protection. I think that I'm faster when I do it solo. I'm not sure though, and I'm really thankful that the tongue joined me. I mean, we will scale the boss, and this will be very, this will be in our advantage. That's why we don't run through the mob side either. Come on, young heal. Guys, if you have suggestions for me for stuff to discuss, if you have questions for me, feel free to ask. If your questions are, how should I say it, like, if they don't make sense to me, or if you are trying to troll or to hate on me, I will just ignore it. It doesn't matter. But I will ignore it. I mean, there are a few, yeah, how shall I say it? In my I sometimes think there are a few people that they are really retarded in the things they post and comment. The stuff they say does not make sense. So I really think that I have a few that, yeah, maybe, yeah, I don't know, that they are unstable in their head or something. But the questions I sometimes get is so much hate in them, and so much nonsense that, yeah, doesn't make sense. Anyway, we're going to scale the boss. I am going to I'm not going to. Are you well? Yeah, it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. This is a close one, I think. Yeah. On my way, buddy. Here we go. Let's see if I picked up all of my gold. Whoa, it seems I did. Whew. Ah, okay. No. Nice. Come on. Almost here. Don't die, bro. Here we go. Watch the health go down now, guys. He might be able to kill me, but he should die faster. Come on. Whoa, it proc'd very first time that I see the weapon proc. he's almost dead. Nice, come on, one time. Please. Nope. Fuck you. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching the video. I hope that you liked it. Once again, a big shout out and thank you to Pesifik for creating my video introduction and my new channel banner. I am going to sign off and get, yeah, it's time for me to sleep. I've been playing for quite a while now. Guys, have a good night. Suggestions, comments, feedback, feel free to post them in the comment section. Yeah, that's it for today. Adios, peace.